What? We're live? No, we're not, but that's the name of the show, and I'm your host, Drew Geraci, and we're here to talk about camera gear and hashtag camera hacks. Today we're talking about the new Datacolor Spyder X Elite, and that's a brand new color calibration tool for your monitors out there. And for anyone that's a photographer or a videographer, having one of these in your photographic toolbox is a must. If you don't have a color calibrated monitor, you're going to have inaccurate colors, and whether you're producing for print or for broadcast, you always want to make sure your color accuracy is on point. So we've tested this one out right here, and I've been using this for the last 5 months or so, and it's a really wonderful tool. I think one of the big things that sets it apart from the previous models, which I've been using the 4, and I never upgraded to the 5, but the big difference is the time it takes. Originally it took 10 minutes to color calibrate, and now it takes less than 2 minutes. As you can see here, the setup is super easy. Just follow the steps and it'll take you right through the prompt from start to finish. And then at the end, you'll have a fully color calibrated monitor. So if you're going back to color grading, whether you're in photo or video, you'll have a much more accurate depiction of what the color was, and you'll get the exact colors that you're getting out of your camera, which is a huge plus. This tool is great for multiple monitors or just one monitor, but it's really cool to be able to see what the before and after was when your monitor wasn't calibrated, so you could just see how poorly color accurate your monitor was. Now, Datacolor did supply us with the unit, so this is a semi-sponsored ad, but I will say I've used Datacolor in the past, and they've always delivered great products. So I would highly recommend this, especially if you aren't using a color calibration tool at the moment. And if you are, I would highly recommend upgrading, because this saves so much time compared to the Spyder 4 and the Spyder 5 that I've used in the past. The only thing to me that kind of stood out as something that was missing was the UI. The UI itself hasn't been updated in 10 years or so, which I think they really should update the UI, but honestly, it's not a deal breaker. All right, guys, if you have any questions or comments, go ahead and put them below. I'll be happy to answer them. And as always, if you like what you saw, feel free to share and subscribe. And what? We're live? No, we're not, but that's the name of the show. And I'm your host, Drew Geraci. We'll see you next time. Happy shooting.